इलिप्स, ओके, पैरामेट्रिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ इलिप्स। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी द डायग्राम ऑफ इट, ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन, एक्स एक्सिस, वाई एक्सिस एंड जेड एक्सिस, दिस इज द ओरिजिन ऑफ द एक्सिस। ओके, सो एज यू नो इलिप्स हैज टू एक्सिस, ओके, वन इज कॉल्ड मेजर एक्सिस, अनदर इज द माइनर एक्सिस। ओके, दिस विल बी द मेजर एक्सिस एंड दिस इज द माइनर एक्सिस। ओके, सो हाफ पोर्शन ए फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट हेयर, हाफ पोर्शन ऑफ मेजर एक्सिस, और यू कैन से सेमी मेजर एक्सिस, एंड फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट सेंटर टू दिस पॉइंट वी विल कॉल्ड इट एज सेमी माइनर एक्सिस। एज दिस इज अ माइनर एक्सिस, हाफ पोर्शन ऑफ दिस एक्सिस फ्रॉम हेयर टू सेंटर ऑफ इलिप्स टू द आर्क ऑफ इलिप्स, सो दिस पोर्शन इज कॉल्ड सेमी माइनर एक्सिस, एंड फ्रॉम द सेंटर टू द आर्क ऑफ इलिप्स कॉल्ड सेमी मेजर एक्सिस। ओके, सो वी आर राइटिंग सेमी मेजर एक्सिस इक्वल टू ए एंड सेमी माइनर एक्सिस इक्वल टू बी। ओके, सो हियर व्हेन फर्स्ट पॉइंट वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट, एंड हियर ऑल्सो लाइक इन सर्कल वी आर स्टार्टिंग हियर यू इक्वल टू हियर स्टार्टिंग यू इक्वल टू 0, एंड अगेन हियर यू विल बी इक्वल टू 90, हियर यू इक्वल टू 180, हियर यू इक्वल टू 270, एंड अगेन वेन यू कम बैक टू दिस पॉइंट देयर द यू विल इक्वल टू 360 डिग्री, सेम लाइक सर्कल। सो द पैरामीटर ऑफ द यू चेंजेस फ्रॉम 0, एंड ऑफ वेन यू डेवलप अ फुल एलिप्स इट विल एंड एट यू इक्वल टू 360 डिग्री। ओके, एंड द फर्स्ट पॉइंट वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग पी एक्स वाई जेड और हेयर, सो हियर वॉट डिस्टेंस इट इज ए, हियर द एंगल इट हैज मेड, यू एंगल इट हैज मेड हो हियर, एंड अगेन फ्रॉम हियर वी आर टेकिंग डेल्टा यू एज अ इंक्रीमेंटल एंगल। ओके, सो द फर्स्ट पॉइंट एक्स विल बी इक्वल टू ए कॉस यू, एज दिस इज अ सेमी मेजर एक्सिस एंड दिस इज अ सेमी माइनर एक्सिस, क्लियर? ओके, सेमी माइनर एक्सिस, सो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग ए कॉस यू, सो एक्स इक्वल टू ए कॉस यू एंड वाई विल बी इक्वल टू बी साइन यू। ओके, सो द फर्स्ट फॉर्मूला ओवर हियर विल बी, एंड दिस डिस्टेंस यू नो फ्रॉम हियर टू द सेंटर इट इज एक्ससी xc, and here this will be from this origin to the center of ellipse will be yc. Okay, so in short what we will do, writing the equation x equal to xc plus a cos u, y equal to yc plus b sin u, and z equal to zc. Z equal to ZC. Okay. Then parametric equation of ellipse by recursive method. There is no difference between circle and ellipse equation. Just only difference is that here A by B, major axis, semi major axis divided by semi minor axis. You see. Can see here it is the equation of circle, XC, here see, just you look down, what is the difference? See, XC, XN minus XC, cos delta U, here also cos delta U, only here you will get A upon B. Okay, this is the ratio we are taking semi major axis divided by semi minor axis. Okay. So only difference between the parametric equation of circle and ellipse is this ratio. Here we have to multiply this ratio a by b. So you have to remember the parametric equation. If you remember the parametric equation of circle and the method how we have developed parametric equation of circle, similarly you can develop the equation for ellipse through same method. Just here difference is the values here are not common. Here a and b values are there, semi major axis and semi minor axis are there. So that's why here ratio will come a by b. Okay, so next parametric equation for inclined ellipse. Okay, if ellipse is inclined by angle of alpha, so this will be, this values will be a change. So here angle alpha will be there as well as opposite side, here alpha angle will be created. Okay, so here value will be this finding the P point x, y, z. Here value will be a cos u into sin alpha, b sin u into cos alpha. Okay, similarly here also a cos u into cos alpha and b sin u into sin alpha. Okay, so here the equation is written as, when a ellipse is inclined, the parametric equation for an inclined ellipse is written as x equal to xc plus a cos u into cos alpha minus b sin u into sin alpha. Okay, similarly for yc plus a cos u into sin alpha plus cos sin u into cos alpha, and z is equal to zc. Okay, here also limit is same, 0 less than or equal to u or less than or equal to 2. This maximum 360 degree it will go. Okay, so for inclined ellipse, so here two angles are made, that's why the values has been changed of x and y axis. So next we will see the numerical. A ellipse has a major axis of 10 units and minor axis of 8 units. See here it has said major axis means it is full axis value and it's a major minor axis full axis. So a and b are the semi major and semi minor axis. So we have to divide it by 2. Okay, so here semi major, to get the semi major axis value, you have to divide 10 by 2. So you will get the value of semi major axis, it is 5. Similarly, minor axis is 8 units. So to get the semi minor axis, you have to divide it by 2. So you will get semi minor axis. Okay, 4 units. Okay, then center point of ellipse is given 5, 6, 3. Okay, then write the parametric equation of an ellipse. Center point we have written xc, yc, zc. So this value respectively we have written. We have drawn an ellipse. Okay. So using the recursive method, we have the equation. So first we have to find out the first coordinate. What it will be? It is a cos u. It is a b sin u. Right? In that form you will write xc plus a cos u, yc plus b sin u. Okay, taking angle u equal to 0 means it will be at an angle of 0. So in short, we are calculating here this point. So you get 10, 6, 3. So this is the starting point from where the ellipse will start. Starting point of the ellipse at angle 0. Okay. Then parametric equation of ellipse. Same we have written, earlier we have seen derivation from that, there we have written. So here a and b values you know. Now you will consider xn, yn here, a previous point to calculate the next point, and center point you know. Center point of the ellipse you know. So using that you can find out the next point. Just you have to decide the incremental angle. So my suggestion for ellipse incremental angle should be maximum 15 degrees you take. to get the smooth ellipse from your arc you have to develop. So take 15, 15, 15, 15 degrees incremental angle. Means delta you should take 15 degrees or 10 degrees. Okay. So next we will see numerical. The ellipse has its major axis 12 units and minor axis 8 units. Inclination of major axis with x-axis is 30 degrees. So your alpha angle is 30 degree. If center of ellipse is 10, 5, 4, means xc, yc, zc, write its parametric equation. So here again it is said major axis and here minor axis. So the terms you have to carefully read. It is not semi-major or semi-minor. So you have to make semi-major and semi-minor value divided by. So you will get A value semi-major, B value semi-minor axis value. Okay. Then above equation we have seen a derivation for that. So from there we can see we can write down the parametric equation. In that put the values of xc, yc, a, b, alpha angle, you put that, and if you want to find out starting point of the ellipse, you take it 0 and you calculate it. You will get the starting point of the inclined ellipse. So like that you have to solve the numericals of ellipse. So not more difference is there between ellipse and circle. Only in circle the radius is constant, and in ellipse the major and minor axis are there. That's why here we are taking the ratio A upon B. Then parabolas, we will see parabolas with point PV, XV, YV and ZV as a vertices. Okay, remember now here the points are vertices. See, first of all you should remember parabola, how parabola is there. Okay, so parabola we will develop in this way: PV, vertex point, first point, then next point, then next n plus 1 point. Okay, so from here we will develop a parabola like this. Okay, so the parametric equation for parabola is written as x equal to xv plus a into u square. Okay, so here we take a into u square, and for y axis, y value, we will take yv plus 2a u. Okay, and z will be zv only. Okay, and here parabola, remember one thing, whenever you are drawing, going for a parabola, hyperbola, the axes are infinite, so the development is infinite, so it we cannot say. So that's why we are taking it as 0 less than u, and here we are going for infinity. So starting from 0 it will go towards infinity. Okay, it might go towards infinity like that. So that's why we are taking here 0 less than or equal to u or less than or equal to infinity. So parametric here written, equation written as a into u square, and here for y we are taking 2a into u. Okay, so from recursive method the equation of parabola is written as xn plus 1 is equal to xn plus yn minus yu delta u plus a delta u square. Similarly, yn plus 1 equal to yn 2a delta u, and zn plus 1 is equal to zn. Okay. So in ellipse, in parabola also, it can make an angle of alpha with respect to x. It might be some inclined parabola is also there. So for that, it will make an angle of alpha. Okay, here. So this is the starting point, vertex of the parabola, and here the first point, then you will get next point, this n plus 1, and like that. So the equation for that, here you just see x equal to xv a u square cos alpha. See here, a u square, just you have to add cos alpha, cos alpha minus 2 a u sin alpha. Okay, similar here also, y equal to yb plus au square sin alpha plus 2au cos alpha. So here the boundary conditions are the same again, 0 less than or equal to u less than or equal to alpha, and z will be zv only. So till now in examination the numericals for parabola is not asked, but you have to remember the parabola, parametric equation for parabola,